see in the whole scent. So, take a little bit of local anesthetic. Stings a wee bit. The next job is to try and get a needle in that structure. Advance the needle. See, it comes off the back wall. If you look down here where the camera is bleeding back, so we're in the right spot. We'll feed a wire into that. See the wire going in. Keep going. The wire further. So we'll take the needle out. It's important to hold tight here when they Bill's clean the thing up, because I have had people pull that thing right out in a heartbeat. So I have to start again when that happens. So we'll try and follow this wire up. You can see it's gone up to here. I'll take this tourniquet off for you. There's a little cranial extension here, so we'll see if we can include that in the capture. So there's the end of the wire right there. Popliteal vein is just below us, so we're in a good spot. Put some more anesthesia just in here. A little nick with the skin, sorry about this. Don't do this, it's hard to get the catheter into the skin. The skin is relatively resistant to this catheter has a little external sheath and an internal obturator, which eases its movement into the vein itself. So let them go. So that catheter is now running up on the wire itself. So it can't really dislodge. I'll just check where the catheter is. You can see there's a little dropout shadow from the echo. That helps to sight where everything is. Just working out the leg. See the end of the catheter. There's the wire sliding in and out of the catheter. Looks like good position. Wire is yours. I'll take the wire out first. Unscrew this little piece, and here's the obturator. It's inside the middle. This is about a 2 French, 3 French. And then this is the laser fiber. This part goes to 1000 degrees centigrade. This part stays cold. You can see blood is appearing up here, which is a good sign. And this slides up, and we'll just engage this lure lock. It's important to make that lure lock pretty tight, because I have pulled on this and left the catheter behind on one or two occasions. And you can see up here now there's a red sign, that's where the tip of the laser is. That's in good position. next step is to push the vein down onto the laser fiber and to push the other tissues away. And we can do that with what's called tumescent anesthesia. There's a pump over there, it's called Klein pump, I think it is. It's important before you actually put this in to blow any bubbles out, because if you put bubbles in the, underneath the skin, it interferes with your image capacity. Feel a little bit of stretching inside your leg as we put this anesthesia in for you. That's going in a wee bit deep, so we'll try and come up a little bit more superficial. See the little shadow drop from the catheters, little stick. You can also see how this vein is in between two sort of layers of tissue. There, the outrunners of Scarpa's fascia, and it helps to keep the anesthesia surrounding the vein itself without too much leaking into the tissues. You can see that structure on the great saphenous vein as well as on the short saphenous vein. Another little stick. So that black stuff you can see on the screen is local anesthetic. It comes from that bag up there. That bag has got Ringer's lactate in it. So we'll have a check and make sure we've got this vein surrounded by a column of black fluid. You can see there's not much fluid right there, so I'll put a bit more anesthesia in. A little stick. See the catheter's way up there, so there's not enough anesthesia at the top. Another little stick, sorry. Let me finish with this part. Sensitive behind the knee. One last look. Okay, that looks all right. So we'll put some glasses on now so that we don't get any laser injury to the eyes. This laser light comes out at about 830 nanometers, which is just the right wavelength to give chronic exposure to people with cataracts. So we usually put these glasses on to help try and reduce that. know this catheter is 30 centimeters long, so we'll just measure what's out here, and it's about 3 centimeters. So that means we've got 27 centimeters of catheter inside on the vein.
May I have any
forceps
left for
I usually run the laser at about 6 watts for a continuous laser beam. And let me know if you feel any pain. Is that all right? No pain?
How many was in?
I think you've got 100 joules right at the top to put a kind of a lid on the top of the vein. And that one that was pulled out stands for 100 joules. We're starting to pull it back. I like to give about 50 joules per centimeter of vein. And in the past, it's reliably closed these veins.
Two.
And that shimmering is where the tip of the laser is. So if this catheter is in 27, I'd like to be up around a count of 13, which would give 50 centimeters per centimeter of vein by the time we're out. Many people don't know who discovered local anesthesia, but it's a kind of a funny answer. And the answer is the psychiatrist Sigmund Freud. Before he became a psychiatrist, he was a neurologist and found that if you dropped cocaine on frog's eyes, the frog didn't care if you opened it or not. Prior to that, there was no local anesthesia. That was in 1876 or thereabouts. Cerebral nerve is in about this position from here to here, so I tend to ease up on the heat. The cerebral nerve, it supplies sensation to the lateral aspect of the heel and ankle, foot, and there's no real point in grabbing that for any reason I can think of.
Nine. You doing okay? Well.
turn the laser off just for coming out through the skin so you don't burn the skin too much. And we'll just have a look up here, make sure the popliteal vein is open and functioning. There's the popliteal vein, which is flashing nicely, and the procedure is done. We'll just clean her up and we'll put her in a compression bandage, hose for about 24 hours, and we'll take the bandage off and keep the hose for about another 3 or 5 days. The patient should get a lot of benefit from this. Good.